And the action about to get underway. Quickly run down the Tallahassee lineup. Tallahassee's wearing their distinctive orange color out there. Looks like things are happening. Number 11, Pixie Pounder. Number 28 is Fern Venomous. Number 2W is Trailer Thrash. The LaVoodoo is wearing the number 32, Aaron Breakabitch. Number 38, action underway now. We'll finish this lineup momentarily, but jammers are out, and it looks like Omaha gets it first as Anna Maniac, who jams a lot for Omaha, makes it through first, but the jammer from Tallahassee is right there with her. As she enters the back of the pack, she has to call it dead, and there will be no points on the initial jam. Number four for Tallahassee is Sox Populi, 4,000, Great Wall of Gina. Number 420 is Stone Her. Wargasm is number 44, Low Mame. Number 499, Antivirus. Number 52, number 57 is Catch-Up. 85 is Courtney Smash. And finally, number 9001, Brattney Cole. Lining up next, the aforementioned Stone Her on the jammer line for Tallahassee, and she faces off against Ima Firestarter, veteran jammer for Omaha, who gets knocked down as she tries to make it out the front of the house by a two-all at Tallahassee. Back on her feet, looking for the open door in the front of the house. Taken down again, having a hard time getting out. Now only one defender in orange stands in her way. This is a second jam, still no score. I'm a fire starter through, lead jammer Omaha. And the jammer, Stone Her, for Tallahassee in orange, for those of you watching the visuals, still hung up as I'm a fire starter knocks on the back door in scoring position.
And she's through for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points, a natural glance slam. Stonehurst still working on her initial pass through the pack, Dwayne.
Yeah, I'm a fire starter, knows a thing or two about jamming. She's going to have to jam against a Tallahassee defense walling up in the back.
And that's a major track cut on Stonehurst. We saw that she was forced out of bounds, failed to re-enter behind the blocker who knocked her out of bounds. Another grand slam scored by I'm a Firestarter. She is now on a grand slam. Pack comes to a complete stop. Here comes I'm a Firestarter. Solid four wall there by Tallahassee. Again, this is Tallahassee in the orange and Omaha in the black and red. And there's another grand slam, Dwayne.
Yeah, I'm a Firestarter has 2 5-point scoring runs so far. She's going in for another one. Omaha on the outside, finds an open lane and just untouched. Makes her third scoring run. It's going to be 15 unanswered so far, and the jam's not over yet.
20 points so far for I'm a Firestarter. She works down her fifth scoring pass.
Yeah, pardon me, that was her fourth scoring run, so 20 points on the board. She's going back for more. It's going to be a big one to start this out for Omaha.
And out of play, she's out for another grand slam. That's 25 points in this jam. Calls it off as Stonehurst was just starting to stand in the penalty box. So I believe we'll have about 10 seconds left of this power jam for Omaha.
Smart.
And coming to the back to the jammer line is Anna Maniac for Omaha. Got lead jammer in that first jam, Dwayne, but was forced to call it off as Low Man was right on her tail. So 25-0 for Omaha in the black versus Tallahassee in the orange.
Yeah, after only two jams, a pretty significant lead by Omaha, the 8 seed over the 9 seed. Tallahassee, 25 unanswered points. And now they send in Anna Maniac, who gets jostled around as she enters, but she's looking for an open lane on the outside. Tallahassee has their jammer back, and on the inside, untouched, Stone Her, lead jammer for Tallahassee, their first in the game. She calls the jam, and Anna Maniac was still hung up in the pack.
I'm not sure if there was a technical issue there or if Stonehurst just wasn't aware of where Anna Maniac was on the track. Either way, we're coming back to it now with number 4,000, the Great Wall of Gina, jamming for Tallahassee.
It's the fourth jam of the game. We've seen 25 points put on the board by Omaha, none by Tallahassee. They're looking to turn it around.
And 964 E-Blast Girl jamming for Omaha, who's up and around on the outside. Lead jammer E-Blast Girl for Omaha.
En route toward a wall of defense on the Tallahassee side.
Oh, she's pushing, trying to get through on the inside all by herself. Omaha was playing all defense there. Now both packs mixing it up. E-Blast Girl out is the Great Wall of Gina. That's her initial pass. Ebon's girl looks to finish off this pass. She does, and quickly calls it off after scoring.
Nice work by the Tallahassee defense. Able to finally let them break on that.
So 29-0, Dwayne Stonehurst. That was a huge mental error. You have to think. I mean, you have lead jammer status. The other jammer hasn't even gotten out of the pack. You have an open scoring opportunity, and she just called it off.
No reason not to capitalize on that.
We'll see if that comes back to bite them. As number 499, Lomame comes back to the jammer line for Tallahassee.
Tallahassee taking a knee to start this thing. They want to get their jammers off the line as soon as possible. I am a fire starter. Jamming again. This is her third timeout.
And Lomame is up and around on the outside. She's lead jammer for Tallahassee. I'm a fire starter. Does now get out of the pack. About 30 to 40 feet separate the jammers. Fairly quick moving pack. Here comes Lomame looking to score points.
Oh, pushed out by the defense of Omaha just as she enters the back of the pack, but they do finally scratch a little nick into the scoreboard to the tune of 2 points. It's going to be 30-2 with 24 minutes left in the first half. This will be the sixth jam as Stonehur, number 420, is sent out for Tallahassee. That's the team in orange if you're watching. She's going to face off against Rady Ruck. This is her first time on the jammer line for Omaha. Good stuff there. Nobody in the penalty box. Relatively clean game so far. This is the sixth jam.
The only trip we've had so far has been the jammer penalty. Rady Ruck forced out of bounds.
Stonehur forced out of bounds as well to the inside. Both jammers have to recycle themselves. Stonehur recovers quicker out the front of the pack, and I believe that she cut one of the
Pass, no penalty.
Yeah, the blocker was out also, but that's enough to keep her from getting lead jammer. But Rady Ruck hung up in the back, and Stonehurst actually going to get some points for it. She catches up to the back of the pack.
She's got the penalty box. Major track cut on Stonehurst.
This is not good news for Tallahassee. Rady Ruck makes her way through, picks up a lead jammer, and calls it off. And actually, that's kind of curious, too. I don't think she had to call that off. I don't think she knew that she was in a power jam.
Well, or she knew felt more confident that she just had a very hard time getting out of that pack.
Right.
So call it off. Let's put in a fresh jammer with fresh legs.
Somebody else might have better luck.
And you've still got the full minute of the power
better
jam.
Better ruck, as it were, making it through this pack.
As it were. Don't forget, folks, you can talk to us on Twitter. The hashtag #talk2, the number 2, #talk2 WFTDA. And Anna Maniac comes in jamming for Omaha. No movement by the Omaha skaters. Out front is Lee Jammer. Anna Maniac coming now. No pack movement in turn one. Solid 4 wall by Tallahassee. They push the action up front, and she is out for a grand slam. Anna Maniac.
Nice work. Yeah, if you're Tallahassee, you absolutely cannot let this happen. You can't let Omaha have the power jam, and if you do, you got to stop her. They only have 3 blockers on the track right now, and that's not enough to do it. 5 more points for Anna Maniac, and Omaha running up this board. She enters the back of the pack again, knocks on the back door.
Forced out of bounds, comes back in. That was looks like a minor track cut. She's out now. Only 4 points. 4 points on that pass, and the power jam ends. And Anna Maniac called it off just as Stonehur was exiting the penalty box. Still had an opportunity to score points there, as that would have been Stonehur's initial pass through the pack. And we've got a timeout Tallahassee.
So it's possible that Anna Maniac was wanting to call that off prior to Stonehur coming out so that they could have one more power jam out of it, and she just didn't get it fired off in time. But either way, the next jam is going to have both jammers on the line, and timeout now called by Tallahassee. The clock frozen at 21:14, and it's 44-2 Omaha over Tallahassee in the first game of the weekend's festivities. The number 9 seed, Tallahassee, taking on the neighbors one door up, Omaha in seed 8. The landlocked lace-up right here in Lincoln, Nebraska, the second time that we have had the South Central Region playoffs in Lincoln. It's always a great time. It's a fantastic, almost, at least for those in the South Central, this is almost one of the iconic venues for Derby. Today's game brought to you in part by Rydell, the official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality and unmatched performance. You can visit them online at RydellSkates.com. That's R-I-E-DellSkates.com. I before E.
All right,
we were taught early on.
With 21 minutes left in the game, 44 to Omaha, 2 for Tallahassee. And just like that, out for lead jammer for Omaha, number 964, E-Blast Girl.
E-Blast Girl, you know, we've, of course, we're more familiar with the South Central than a lot of regions, and we've seen Omaha quite a bit, but E-Blast Girl, we have not seen jam as much as I Am a Firestarter and Animaniac. They've kind of been more of the staples, but E-Blast Girl doing great.
E-Blast Girl calls it off, but Great Wall of Gina had gotten out of the pack and was able to sneak through for 2 more points there for Tallahassee, bringing their total now to 4 points. It's got to be really disappointing, Dwayne. You come out of a timeout that your team called. You don't get lead jammer status, but then Great Wall of Gina with a good burst of speed there at the end to at least eke 2 points out of that jam. So 4-2 Omaha over Tallahassee in that last jam makes the score now 48-4 for Omaha in the orange versus Tallahassee in the black.
20 minutes left in the first half. Going out next will be I Am a Firestarter, veteran for Omaha. And, man, she makes it look like the pack isn't even there. Makes it through immediately, and maybe the pack isn't actually there because the jammer, Low Mame, number 499 for Tallahassee, makes her way out as well.
But Low Mame is about to catch her, Dwayne.
Yeah.
I have a Firestarter forced to call it off.
She knew it. She knew she was there. Could
and
feel her breath.
No points scored for either jammer. Remember, as I'm sure most of us know watching this broadcast here on WFTDA.TV, it's hips in front of hips. The jammer's hips have to get in front of the blocker's hips while they're both in bounds in order for the point to be scored. So no points scored by either jammer on that last jam.
Yes, sir. And if she had gotten any points, then she would have been giving away points to Low Mame for Tallahassee as well. So now Tallahassee sends in Stone Her, and she faces off against Animaniac. The pack lines up on the pivot line.
Stone Hurd laying some hits on Animaniac. Animaniac is out for lead jammer. 20 feet behind her, though, is Stone Hurd. Pack composition becomes very important.
The jammers for Tallahassee are actually doing a pretty good job of when they're not the first one. They're, oh, on the inside. I don't.
No points scored by either jammer. I agree with that. Animaniac passed her blockers after she was out of bounds. Stone Her passed her blockers after the jam whistle had been called.
Right. She, that would have been a cut track major for sure. But the because she didn't jump the apex. She dissected it.
She did dissect the apex.
She steamrolled the apex and cut everybody, but the jam had already been called dead.
So still 48-4 with 18 and a half minutes left. E-Blast Girl coming to the jammer line for Omaha. And number 4,000, Great Wall of Gina for Tallahassee. Low-moving pack, both jammers in the back. Now Great Wall of Gina comes around. She's through. Lead jammer, Great Wall of Gina.
Tallahassee trying to get something going here. So far, they do still have E-Blast Girl for Omaha hung up in the pack, although now she comes out.
Forced to be released by 20 feet, but here comes Great Wall of Gina looking to score points. Pack gets spread out. E-Blast Girl comes towards the back. Gina calls it off. Score 2 points there.
She got pushed out by the defender for Omaha.
So Tallahassee has scored in 3 jams at 2 points each per jam.
May Kit Rain was the defender from Omaha who made that happen.
All right, I'm a Firestarter comes back to the jammer line for Omaha. And Low Mame again for Tallahassee. Both teams settling into a pretty solid 3 jammer rotation. I'm a Firestarter comes around to the outside. She was untouched, Wayne. She's through for lead jammer, but right behind her is Low Mame, 10 feet. And closing, separate these jammers as Low Mame is starting to catch up.
And I Am a Firestarter actually only had 1 blocker to contend with, so that certainly helped. Man, Low Mame got in front of her, though. I'm a Firestarter actually called it dead just as Low Mame was knocking on the back door, but kept her from getting any points. It remains 48-6 with 17-13 Omaha in the lead.
So Animaniac comes back to the jammer line for Omaha. Stone Her, number 420. Get it?
Yeah, I see what she did there.
See what she did there. Yep.
And a maniac pulling double duty. Two jams in a row, but Stoneher gets out first. Lead jammer Tallahassee. However, Animaniac right there with her, and she's going to have to call it dead. Well, maybe Stoneher's going to try to sneak in. She does, and she calls it. And she gets 4 points, and Animaniac gets none. I cannot believe she was able to pull that off.
That was the most perfectly executed hit it and quit it I've seen in a while.
Jiminy.
Spun through a round on the outside as she was calling it off, got all 4 points, none for Omaha. That was a really solid move by Stoneher there.
There was a split second before or after, and that wouldn't have been that wouldn't work. I can't believe it. Rady Ruck now lines up on the line once again for Omaha, and she faces off against Great Wall of Gina once again. Still just heavy blocker penalties on Tallahassee. Rady Ruck takes advantage to become lead jammer immediately. Gina still stuck behind the pack as the blockers just now get around turn two.
Here comes Rady Ruck on a scoring pass. Only two blockers to contend with. Pack pretty spread out. Great Wall of Gina does get out. Rady Ruck looks to finish her pass. She does. Scores 4 points and calls it off.
It's going to make it 52-10. Omaha over Tallahassee with just under 16 minutes left in the first half. I am a fire starter now goes to the line for Omaha. Number 499, Lomain, going to jam again for Tallahassee. And Tallahassee still missing a blocker. Actually, it's three-on-three defense this time. Got a blocker from either side in the box. 52-10 again.
Both teams doing some interesting pack composition pre-jam. Talk more about that later. Is Lomame up front now? Lomame is around. She's out. Lead jammer Lomame for Tallahassee.
Yeah, Lomame moving out there, and I'm a fire starter still stuck in the pack. So maybe an opportunity for Tallahassee to get some points on the board here. I'm a fire starter now contending with a two wall in the front as Lomain enters the back of the pack and passes 1-2-3. Oh, pushed out by the defender for Omaha, number 215, Bellicose.
Lomain's now up front. Here comes I'm a fire starter. Lomain calls it off. Looks like she did call it off in time. No, excuse me, 1 point scored there by Lomain, but 4 points. 4 points for Lomain, 1 point for I'm a fire starter. Makes a score 53-14. With just under 15 minutes left as we are halfway through the first half, entering our 16th jam. An unusual number of jams here as both teams have just, we've had very, very brief hit
right.
And quit it jams to this point.
Short burst, just like that last one, a net gain of 3 for Tallahassee. Every little bit helps. 42 points is still the spread with Omaha in front. Just under 14 minutes left in the first half.
Animaniac versus Stoneher. And Stoneher saw a line on the inside, forced out of bound, and out now is Animaniac. She is not lead jammer. She is the jammer in the lead, but she is not lead jammer. Stoneher gets out. Also no lead. We're going to go the full 2 minutes, Dwayne.
So we were just talking about the short jams, but we're not going to have one this time. Animaniac finds an open lane on the inside. Quick 4 points, Stoneher enters, and she tries to follow her up the same open lane. It gets shut a little bit. She takes some turbulence, but she makes it through also. 4 points for either team. Now both jammers going in for a second scoring run. Both go to the inside. Once again, Animaniac through with no problem. So 4 more points for Omaha, and Stoneher for Tallahassee looking to answer him, but she is stuck behind a four wall of Omaha.
Pack comes to a complete stop. Here comes Animaniac again. Stoneher forced out of bounds. Big spill in turn three. And major low block on Stoneher. She is going to the penalty box. We've got a power jam now for Omaha.
Yeah, Bellicose, the defender for Omaha, goes to the box as well.
Solid hit by Wargasm for Tallahassee on Animaniac. She's forced to go all the way back and recycle to the front.
Oh, man, and the entire pack spills to the inside. Animaniac wants to take advantage to go to the outside, but one of the blockers from Tallahassee noticed.
And
oh, it sent her out, and she cut her as she came back in. That is her fourth minor, and she goes to the box. So a reprieve in the penalty box for Lomain, the defender, or the jammer, rather, for Tallahassee, who gets to come back onto the track now.
So Stoneher back onto the track for Tallahassee. With just 3 seconds left in this jam. right around the inside for 5 points. And that's the end of the jam as the 2 minutes ticks down. Dwayne, we're going to have about 40 seconds of power jam here for Tallahassee. You see them already lining up, setting up the sausage as they send out number 499, Low Mame. So, solid opportunity here for Tallahassee as they're down 61-23. But, they're going to have about 40 seconds as it looks like Omaha is taking a timeout. Solid opportunity here for Tallahassee to get back into this game. And if you want to get back into the game, if you're tired of sliding through slippery corners, you need to get some Radar Wheels. Try the new Radar Villain Wheel. Check them out on the web at radarwheels.com. We'd also like to thank our following WFTDA.TV partners, Blood and Thunder Magazine, Derbyology, and Derbalife. Folks, if you're out there just listening to us on the free audio feed, you really absolutely please consider upgrading. Only $12 for the entire weekend. That breaks down to 70 cents a game.
Yeah, that's actually less than the price of one single home bout for your favorite team at home. I mean, usually it's what, 13, 16 bucks to go see a roller derby game? For 12, or
$12.
For 12, you can actually see all 17 games over the weekend. So,
an amazing high quality right here on WFTDA.TV. Don't forget you can also talk to us on Twitter, the hashtag #talk2WFTDA. And if you're needing to follow along at home, the Twitter score, the @WoofedAlive Twitter feed, will be tweeting the scores and happenings as they occur. So we're coming back to it, Dwayne. Again, Low Mame coming to the jammer line for Tallahassee in the orange, 61-23 with just under 12 minutes left. Only two blockers for each team, no pack to start. Low Mame forced out of bounds. That is Molly Masker with a solid hit. Now out for lead jammer is Low Mame, Dwayne.
Yeah, Low Mame made quick work of a very skimpy pack. Eyes set on the backfield, and oh, man, untouched on the inside. Five-point grand slam, which I point out, just in case you're not as familiar with Derby, that in Derby, grand slam is actually worth 5 points. And she gets a second one here, so 10 unanswered points for Tallahassee. They're doing the right thing if they want to get back into this.
Anna Maniac is out of the penalty box, finished her initial pass. Low Mame's not aware of this. Here's now a scoring pass for Anna Maniac, who gets through for 4 points. Low Mame, though, coming full speed. Maybe this is, you've got a blocker advantage here. Does call it off after scoring 5 more points. So solid jam there by Tallahassee as they bump the needle 65 now to 43. And with one power jam and one well-executed jam with that power jam status, Tallahassee's right back in this game.
Yeah, 65-43. Man, can't beat that, huh? Tallahassee fighting to the end. 10.5 minutes left till halftime. Great Wall of Gina standing on the line once again when the action resumes. I am a fire starter
for Omaha. The jam has started. Team's doing, it looks like Tallahassee doing a slow start, trying to spring some of their blockers from the penalty box. I'm a fire starter with some initial contact on Great Wall of Gina. Both jammers now coming into the pack. I'm a fire starter's up front. I'm a fire starter is out for lead jammer, but 5 feet behind her is Great Wall of Gina.
Yeah, that's a
closing. Great Wall of Gina is around in front of I'm a Firestarter.
Huge key for Tallahassee staying in this thing is the fact they've been able to usually match whatever points Omaha scores more often than not, or force them to call off the jam by sticking with them. And no exception this time. I'm a Firestarter scores four. Gina answers them, but this time I'm a fire starter enters the pack, and she has actually put some distance on Gina, and so the second scoring run for I'm a fire starter is unanswered. 8 points for Omaha on the jam, only 4 for Tallahassee. That makes it 73-47, 9:15 left in the first half.
Coming back to the jammer line for Tallahassee in the orange is Stone Her. For Omaha in the black, Anna Maniac. Looks like we've got 3-on-2 blocker advantage for Tallahassee over Omaha. And we're coming back to it. Oh, up front and around. Stone, her lead jammer for Tallahassee. Anna Maniac still in the back of the pack. Now she comes through, jumps the apex, does it successfully. But here's Stone, her scoring pass, who comes around on the outside untouched, Wayne. calls it off. Four more points for Tallahassee. And Tallahassee
sneaking back in.
Looking good. They were the jam where we had the jammer rotation in the penalty box. You could really see the fatigue starting to come into play there with that two-minute jam. Tallahassee, though, looks fresh. They've got some spring in their step.
I'm a fire starter going out next for Omaha and facing off once again, as she has several times in this game, against Low Maine. Only two defenders on the track for Omaha and three for Tallahassee. Low Maine takes advantage of that fact, and she is not out first. No, I'm a fire starter actually snuck out first and got lead jammer, but then Low Maine got way out in front of her, a good 15 feet in front of her, and so you know what's going to happen next. I'm a fire starter shuts it down. No points for anybody. Under 8 minutes to go before halftime. It remains 73-51, Omaha over Tallahassee.
Don't forget to check out Adam Wheels, a proud partner and the official wheel of the WFTDA. Adam Wheels on the web at adamwheels.com. All right, Anna Maniac coming back to the jammer line for Omaha. Great Wall of Gina for Tallahassee. 73-51, 7.5 minutes left in this first half.
3-on-2 defense in favor of Tallahassee, just like last time. Gina trying to take advantage of it, but no, she gets stopped in the front, and Anna Maniac finds her way out first. Lead jammer, Omaha.
But right behind her, Great Wall of Gina was able to close the distance, and now Great Wall of Gina is engaging Anna Maniac. Anna Maniac slowing down. Looks like we've got now 4-on-3 Packer advantage for Tallahassee. Here comes the jammers into the pack.
Knocked to the inside by Pixie Pounder, the defender for Tallahassee, and that ends the play.
That was a solid jam by Animaniac to hold on to Great Wall of Gina. Keep it slow, keep it slow. They approach the pack. Right as they got it to the pack, she squirted up front. She's able to get 1 point for her team for Omaha. None on that last jam for Tallahassee.
And that was that blocker, Pixie Pounder, actually was the one who gave up the point, but she also kept her from getting any more by bumping her out.
Mm-hmm.
She was in front of Pixie Pounder when she went out of bounds, and then she called it out.
All right, Stoneher versus I'm a Fire Starter. I'm a Fire Starter looks for the inside. It's there. She's out. She's lead jammer. I'm a Fire Starter for Omaha. Stoneher is up front, gets out as well.
She's both bumped around on the outside, but she stayed on her feet and made it in there. And this time, finally, I'm a Fire Starter has some breathing.
Oh! She did. Stoneher gets out and...
No, and I'm a fire starter on a low block major. No, it had to be one of the... Somebody got a low block major and sent to the box, and I don't swear it wasn't the jammer.
I think it was. I think that was a major low block on Stoneher, who is not sitting in the penalty box. We see the refs running around.
Yeah, I don't think that they got the memo yet, but we're going to see a quick official timeout to clarify this. There was a gorgeous
apex jump by Stoneher was what caused Dwayne and I to get so excited. I'm a fire starter, had lead jammer status, was in the process of calling it off as Stoneher
came out of nowhere, just in the air, and the Omaha jammer actually picked up she must have picked it up after she called the jam, but before all four whistles blew, because she's sent to the box.
Well, currently the score shows that 3 points were scored on that last jam by Omaha and 4 by Tallahassee. So if the call stands that was made, that was a 4-point correctly done apex jump by Stoneher.
I'm a Fire Starter has been by far the biggest spread winner on the jammer line for Omaha so far this game. Stoneher is the top jammer for Tallahassee in the first half thus far.
So 22 jams now. Lead jammer status has gone to Tallahassee, only unofficial stats-wise, 6 times. And looks like we've got an official word from our head referee. We'll wait for 1 minute. Omaha has asked for an official review on the last scoring pass.
So she had just entered, and she, you know what they're wanting is, they're probably talking about the Tallahassee side where she jumped the apex and got that 4 points in one fell swoop as she was calling it off. I bet they're arguing that it didn't count.
I'm assuming they're either arguing that it happened after the last jam, after the last whistle of the fourth whistle to call off the jam, or that it was that there was a penalty that occurred when she made the jump. It looked to me, and it was so fast, it was an amazing jump by Stonehurst for Tallahassee. It looked to me like she stuck the landing. There was some contact, but I think the contact occurred after she had made contact with her skates on the ground. So I think the legality of the call, of the jump that was the call, was the correct one based upon what I saw. And it was so bam, bam. I mean, the refs have the best perspective on the call. I have to agree. I think the 4 points that were given were given correctly.
Yeah,
so.
I don't think we're going to see this flipped. And incidentally, I thought that there was a low block major on the jammer for Omaha, but actually it was on one of the blockers.
So as it stands now, 5.5 minutes left in the first half, 77 for Omaha in the black, 55 for Tallahassee in the orange. Looks like we've got Animaniac coming back to the jammer line for Omaha, and number 499, Low Mame, for Tallahassee.
You see an Omaha fan with a sign in the stands that says, good call, ref. That's nice.
And waiting for the referee to turn the microphone on. And using an old school microphone.
The DIY aspect of roller derby is alive and well, ladies and gentlemen.
So as we suspected, the points stand. The official review, no call was overturned. That should not have counted as a timeout against Omaha, so I suspect we'll see the number two there on your screen. Upticked up to three.
22-point lead by Omaha, 77-55. 5.5 minutes left in the first half. Animaniac standing on the line, facing off against Low Mame. One blocker missing after a low block major on the Omaha side. Tallahassee has all four of theirs. Low Mame up the gut lead jammer for Tallahassee.
Low Mame, the wall was open in the middle. She came right through. Animaniac, though, about 10 feet behind her. Both of these jammers very speedy. Here comes the jammers into the pack. Omaha was all the way on the outside with all their blockers. 4 points there for Tallahassee, none for Omaha. That was a poor pack setup by Omaha as they had all their blockers on the outside in a line. There's no way to
engage. No reason
the jammer
for it.
Yeah, you really gave away 4 points there. So that makes the score now 59 for Tallahassee, 77 for Omaha. Under 5 minutes left now as we've got the Great Wall of China coming to the jammer line for Tallahassee.
Omaha has been dominant this entire game, but Tallahassee chipping away at it. It's only 18 points now. You know what? And little mayhem.
There was a whistle. Great Wall of China did start moving forward. Now, all you've got to do with a false start minor, an illegal procedure minor, is, you know, give up position, which she does, so it should not be a major. Great Wall of China is still eligible for lead jammer status if she gets out, which she does. Lead jammer, Great Wall of China.
Tallahassee in orange, not going down without a fight. En route to the backfield, the Omaha jammer still hung up. Gina, the jammer for Tallahassee, enters the back of the pack on turn three. Gets a grand slam, so 5 more points for Tallahassee.
On the fire starter, does now get out of the pack. 50 feet separate the jammers. Here comes Great Wall of Gina into the back of the pack. There's one, there's two. Calls it. Called it off.
Complete her second scoring run, called it off. She got 3 points for it. She got bumped by one blocker and didn't get the point. But 8 unanswered points for Tallahassee, and now it's only a 10-point lead by Omaha with 3.5 minutes left in the first half. So Tallahassee every bit in this thing.
Remember, you got 2 points. She got 2 points for the two blockers she passed, plus 1 point for the blocker in the penalty box. Stonehurst comes to the jammer line for Tallahassee. Animaniac on the jammer line for Omaha.
3 blockers on either side. 1 blocker in the box for both teams. Animaniac on the outside.
Stonehurst on the inside. Stonehurst is out.
Gets there first. How about that?
Stonehurst is lead jammer, but Animaniac 20 feet behind. And very, very quick moving pack, Dwayne. The pace has been set at a very quick speed.
Yeah, we've seen a lot of contrast in pack speed during this game.
Now Stonehurst checks to see where Animaniac is. Looks like she considered doing some jammer action. Calls it off 2 points to 1 point. Jam win there for Omaha as they did not have lead jammer, but they were able to outscore Tallahassee 2 points to 1. So 79-68, an 11-point spread for Omaha with under 3 minutes left in this first half. I'm a fire starter comes back to the jammer line for Omaha. Lomame back to the Jammer line for Tallahassee. Again, Tallahassee in the orange, Omaha in the black.
Omaha taking a big wall on the knee in front of the pivot line. Jiminy Christmas taken down on the inside. And Animaniac taking advantage of the mayhem. I'm a fire starter to become lead jammer for Omaha quickly. And caught back up on the inside. 5-point grand slam.
Lomame does now get out of the pack, completes her initial pass. About 50 feet as here comes I'm a fire starter on another scoring pass. Jumps it, calls it. 4 more points. So that was a 9-point jam there by Omaha. That's got to feel good. You get a grand slam without the power jam happening. 88-68, 20-point spread. Under 2 minutes left in the first half. Time for one, maybe two more jams in this first half.
There's some that call that a natural grand slam.
And that's
free-range, organic grand slam. And now lining up. Animaniac for Omaha facing off against Gina once again.
Oh, Animaniac threw right in the middle. Tallahassee defense fell asleep, and she is out for lead jammer.
And they better not do it again as Animaniac enters the back of the pack. They're not going to. They put up a solid three wall in the back. Gina might have an opportunity to catch up. Animaniac taken down. As Gina enters the back, Gina does not get any points for it, and Omaha actually gets three. So Omaha wanting to pull away again.
Solid effort, though, there by Great Wall of Gina as the speed and burst she had there at the end forced Animaniac to call it off.
91-68, less than a minute left.
So 32 seconds tick down on the game clock. Remember, when the game clock ticks to zero, we finish the jam that we're on. As number 777, Rady Ruck back with the jammer line. She's lead jammer for Omaha, but right behind her is the Tallahassee jammer, Dwayne.
Yeah, and they haven't utilized Rady Ruck much. Stone Her, the jammer for Tallahassee, right there with her. Both jammers on route. Rady Ruck taken down by Stone Her, and Stone Her is going to make a break for the backfield. Rady Ruck's going to stop her before it happens.
Six seconds left. If either team wants to call a chant timeout to get another jam in, they don't.
No.
Which I agree with. Save your timeouts. Each team has used one. So that is the first half. Really exciting start.
The thing that's really intriguing me, we've seen a couple of major mental snafus on the part of both teams, but some high-level play out of both these teams so far. Really solid pack awareness for the most part, knowing when to move up, move down, take a knee, all those sort of advanced strategies. Both teams have been executing them fairly well so far.
Well, and one thing that is striking about the makeup of this game so far is the ability of the jammers to get out of the pack has been almost identical for both teams the entire time, which is why we've seen why we saw 30 jams in the first half is because they're almost always neck and neck coming out of the pack. So you got to call off the jam earlier, you know, and we've seen a lot of no score or 4-4 scores. So we'll see if it turns out that way in the second half.
And just like that, I'm a fire starter. The Tallahassee defense was moved entirely to the outside line. She had a wide open lane on the inside. She's out for lead jammer. Great Wall of Gina jamming for Tallahassee in the orange is still in the back. As here comes I'm a fire starter on a scoring pass.
Oh, man. And great job by the Wall of Omaha to take the two blockers that are on the track for Tallahassee. Put them to the side. I'm a fire starter able to just stroll down Broadway and put 5 points on the board.
I'm a fire starter comes now into the pack again. Great Wall of Gina still looking for her initial pass. I'm a fire starter is out for another 100% organic, 4 points. Look for the call from the refs. No indicator of why there was 4 versus 5, but either way, that's 9 points thus far in this jam as I'm a fire starter now through. A little hop on the inside apex.
And this time she got a 100% organic, free-range, natural Kobe beef grand slam. She's going back for another one.
Well, Great Wall of Gina is out of the pack and calling it off. I'm a fire starter.
I do not think she did it in time. She did not. The Tallahassee jammer enters for a point. She'll take it.
So a 14-point jam there for I'm a Firestarter for Omaha versus only 1 point for Great Wall of China, as the defense there by Omaha just did a solid wall on containing Great Wall of China for over a minute in that jam.
You cannot complain about a 13-point net gain.
All right, so Stoneher comes to the jammer line for Tallahassee, and a Maniac for Omaha.
Got a full defense. One blocker in the box for Tallahassee. Everybody from Omaha is in it.
And Stoneher comes to the outside. And a Maniac now up front. Both jammers up front. Who's going to get out first? It's, I believe, and a Maniac.
And she immediately gets some turbulence out of Stoneher, who gets in front, and she's going to make her work a little bit and then call it dead before they get there.
Stoneher is not the lead jammer. She is the jammer in the lead.
Fast-moving pack, though. Really cooking with gas. Stoneher, he's like, what are you waiting for? And finally, Animaniac pulls the trigger. No points for anybody.
Kind of a delayed call there, as there was only one blocker in the penalty box, and that was a Tallahassee blocker.
Yeah.
So a little favor there done there for Tallahassee by Animaniac. 105-69, just under about 27 and a half minutes left in this first half. Jammer
in the game,
in the game. For this first time tonight, jamming for Omaha, number 39, Midlife Crashes. And we've got a official timeout.
Midlife Crash is kind of definitely a staple of the Omaha Roller Girl, so it's funny that we haven't seen her on the jammer line until now, but here she is, sent out a fresh jammer. Got one more secret weapon they save for the second half.
And they sub her out for I'm a Firestarter.
All right.
I have to think there must have been some sort of technical issue for I'm a Starter. Either way, we're back to it. I'm a Firestarter is around on the outside. She's lead jammer for Omaha, but right behind her, about 20 feet, is Low Mame for Tallahassee. Three wall in the back is the defense set up for Tallahassee. Now they move forward. Here comes the jammers.
Low Mame sent to the outside, has to recycle herself. And I'm a Firestarter taking her time calling it. She gets 1 point, none for Low Mame. She was bumped out by the back blocker and never got back on the track in time. 1 point gain for Omaha. It's now 106-69, 26:45 left in the contest. Great Wall of China stands on the line now for Tallahassee. Faces off against Animaniac. Four defenders on the track for Tallahassee, only two for Omaha. So we'll see if Gina is able to.
Low Mame just came on. They did a little jammer sub of their own. So the Low Mame now jamming for Tallahassee, not Great Wall of Gina.
Sure
and a Maniac is up front and through on the inside. Low Mame is out. She is not your lead jammer. Track cut, no pass, no penalty. Minor back block on Animaniac. We do not have a lead jammer. We're going 2 minutes. Here's the jammers looking to score points around on the outside.
Low Mame just flattened as she enters the back of the pack, and Animaniac takes advantage. That defender who did it gets sent to the box for it.
So Omaha bit of a bad spot here, as they are full in the penalty box. Only one blocker on the track right now for Omaha.
Great opportunity for Low Mame to catch up a little bit. They're currently down by 41 points. Low Mame enters the back of the pack. Animaniac makes a quick pass through for 4 points. Low Mame matches her for those 4 points.
Pack sets up now 3-on-3.
Tallahassee's got to stop Animaniac. Oh, they don't. And in fact, it's Low Mame who gets stopped. Low Mame, the jammer for Tallahassee. Animaniac for Omaha. The Omaha jammer makes it through for 4 more points. And Low Mame for Tallahassee stopped. And now Animaniac is going to lap her. A 5-pointer for Animaniac. And this has backfired on Tallahassee. They had a huge defensive advantage at the beginning of this jam, but they are not able to capitalize on it. Low Mame now comes out of the front. They still have a defensive advantage, as
there's no pack anywhere on here.
Jeez.
Low Mame able to get out for another 4 points.
Yeah, pack truthfully, nobody has a defensive advantage this second.
Both jammers come through virtually untouched. 4 points to 4 points.
Spending spree on this jam. Everybody's getting points. 24 and a half minutes left. Comes to an end on time.
I have to imagine we're going to see an official timeout here. There was so many blocker penalties being assigned in that last jam. Looks like the Omaha coach out talking to the refs. So 134 to 89, really high scoring jam for both teams there. 24 minutes left in the game. Great Wall of China comes to the jammer line for Tallahassee in the orange, and we've got an
official timeout. You called it.
WFTDA would like to thank the following South Central Region playoff partners: Blood and Thunder Magazine, Bones Bearings, Bont Skates, Cruise Skate Shop, Derby for All, Derby Love, Derby Skids, Fast Girl Skates, Five Stride Mag, 5on5mag.com, Pritco, Sin City, Sisu Mouth Guards, Vanilla Skates, Viva Las Vegas, and Wicked Skatewear. We also want to thank our official sponsor, Iron Doll Clothing. Iron Doll Clothing provides custom uniforms for the modern roller girl and referee, lifting and separating since 2009. Find them on the web at irondollclothing.com. And, of course, our official sponsor of the Bracket Bonanza, 2-in-1 Skate Shop. Take 10% off your entire order at 2in1skateshop.com when you use the coupon code BONANZA during checkout. 2-in-1 Skate Shop, shock the competition. You can find them on the web at the number 2N, number 1, Skate Shop with two P's and an E, 2in1skateshop.com. And we're coming back to it, Dwayne.
Couple of things happened during that official timeout. They recounted the penalties from the first half, and they also did a points review from the last jam. But both actually stand. So, you know, just shoring things up a little bit. I'm a fire starter standing on the line now, facing off against Great Wall of China. There are only two blockers on the field for either team, a micro pack, as it were. And we'll see what comes out of it. 24:03 left in the contest. 134 to 89, Omaha on top of Tallahassee.
One whistle is the pack. No pack to start. Off go the jammers. Great Wall of China is up and around. Great Wall of China is lead jammer for Tallahassee. Still in the micro pack, but out now is I'm a Fire Starter. 60 feet separate the jammers. We've got a very fast-moving pack, Dwayne.
Yep, we do indeed. And now one of the defenders from Tallahassee regains it, so comes back on the track. So Tallahassee now with a defensive advantage, 3-2, and Great Wall of China makes her way through the pack for 4 points. Yep, one scoring run for China. And now it's 134-93 with 23 and a half minutes left in the game.
That was the first lead jam that we've seen for Tallahassee in this second half. The first four went all to, the first three went all to Omaha before we had the no lead jammer jam. We've got Animaniac coming back to the jammer line for Omaha versus Stonehur for Tallahassee.
Pack is off. The jammers are off. Stonehur enters the pack first, but on the inside, Animaniac picks up lead jammer for Omaha.
10 feet behind her, though, is Stonehur. Stonehur quick, and Stonehur cuts in front of Animaniac. She's now got jammer advantage, positional advantage. Animaniac calls it off.
Still a crazy light pack. We didn't see a lot of blocker penalties in the first half, but we are getting our share in the second half, making up for lost time.
So Stonehur, you got to give kudos to her on that last jam. Did not get lead jammer, but was able to close the gap and get in front of Animaniac with a nice move coming around on turn one on the inside line to get the positional advantage and force a 0-0 jam.
And we've seen a lot of that out of Tallahassee in this game. They've actually done a really good job of, if they don't get lead jammer, they make the best out of it.
All right, I'm a fire starter versus Lo Mame. Both jammers up front. Both jammers are out, and it is Lo Mame, lead jammer for Tallahassee. And getting in front of her, almost in front of her, both jammers with a nice speed skate apex.
Yeah, and there you go. You know what? Actually, Omaha's doing the same thing back to Tallahassee. Mm-hmm. When they don't get lead jammer, they make the best out of it as well.
Both jammers come into the pack with a scoring pass.
Wow, and just a package deal as both jammers get thrown to the inside.
But and, 3 points were scored there by I'm a Fire for Omaha, none for Tallahassee. So didn't get lead jammer, but getting the points was I'm a Fire starter for Omaha. Makes the score 137 to 93, Omaha over Tallahassee, 21 and a half minutes left.
Now she passed two of the blockers before she went out of bounds and then got the third one, the ghost point for the defender from Tallahassee, who's still sitting in the box. Great Wall of China is who the orange team sends out now, and she faces off against the jammer who actually gets lead jammer for Omaha, Animaniac. But once again, we see both jammers just breathing down each other's neck. Animaniac, though, actually able to capitalize and not give any away. 4 points for Animaniac, and she calls it at just the right time.
That was a solid play there. We want to thank the rest of our WFTDA.TV sponsors, Derbyology, Derby for Life, Derby for All, Derby Skins, Fast Girl Skates, Five Stride, Jammer Up, and Wicked Skatewear, as well as Blood and Thunder Magazine, the official WFTDA.TV partners. Thank you guys so much for your support of this pretty amazing package you're seeing, Dwayne. If you're watching the high-quality feed, it really is something else. If you're listening to us on the audio feed, again, I don't mean to sound like a shill here, but it's $12. It's $12.
Yeah,
it's $12.
And this tournament is going to be this way this entire time. We've got the very first game on Friday morning of the entire tournament, and it's been really exciting so far. You know, the number 8, number 9 seed taking on each other, and it's just been a real treat to see Tallahassee stick in it. And you know, every time Omaha gets a lead jammer, Tallahassee's right there with them, and Omaha's doing the same thing back to them. It's been just a fantastic roller derby contest.
All right, as the Tallahassee uses their second timeout, good time. I think that's a good time to call a timeout. You got one left to save it if you need it for the end of the game. But take a second to talk about where you're
take
going.
Take a breath. Get back into this thing. You're down 50 points, but, you know, you can turn it around. There's 20 minutes left.
Oh, and turning it around is Great Wall of Gina coming back to the jammer line after that timeout. She's through for lead jammer.
It'll certainly help. Now the Omaha jammer cleared for takeoff as well. There is one, make it two blockers in front of her. They keep her at bay. And Stone Herr plunges into the back of the pack in scoring position. Omaha is now in scoring position herself. Already there scoring points as Stone Herr finds an open lane on the inside, a two wall in front. Push to the outside. She calls the jam. She thinks she scored 3 points, and she is right. Three unanswered points for Omaha Tallahassee. And Tallahassee chipping away at this what was close to a 50-point lead. They've had it down as low as 10 in the first half, trying to stay in it. Under 20 minutes left, 141-96, Omaha over Tallahassee. Now Great Wall of Gina stands on the line for Tallahassee. And she faces off against I Am a Firestarter. Staple jammer for Omaha. Four wall in the front for Omaha. Three defenders on the track.
Oh, but around on the outside, I'm a Firestarter is out lead jammer for Omaha. Great Wall of Gina now pushes her way towards the front.
It was a solid wall in the front of the defense for Omaha, but it has fallen apart, and that gives Gina an opportunity, but they still hold her at bay, and I'm a Firestarter is going to catch up. Looks like Gina does come out in the front of the pack for Tallahassee, so I'm a Firestarter, the jammer for Omaha, will not get a grand slam. And actually, she's not even going to get all 4 points. She got pushed out to the inside. She calls the jam three and out for the second time in a row.
Mm-hmm. That's right. But
this time it's Omaha. So
past that last blocker while she was out of bounds, therefore no fourth point on that pass.
18:50. It's 144-96 Omaha on top.
Lomame versus Animaniac. And Lomame for Tallahassee, Animaniac for Omaha. Omaha wearing the black, Tallahassee wearing the orange. No pack is the call. Both jammers are released. Oh, Lomame comes through on the inside. Got one to get past. She does. Lomame is lead jammer for Tallahassee.
This is the way it's done, man. You just stick in there. Keep getting lead jammer where you can. Get a positive net gain where you can. Omaha jammer still stuck in the box. Lomame, the jammer for Tallahassee, trying to chip away at it. She enters the back of the pack at scoring position. Taken down in three different directions by
and
the defense
major,
from Omaha.
Major low block
on
Lomame is going to give Animaniac the jammer for Omaha. A power jam now. We're going to...
You have got to fall small when you hit the floor. If you cause a traffic jam like that, you're going to get burned for it. And now Omaha has the field all to themselves. I'm a Firestarter. Puts a grand slam on the board. She goes back for a second one. A four wall in the front by Tallahassee trying to hold her at bay and eat up this penalty clock.
All four blockers for Tallahassee. Tallahassee very wisely bridging to the Omaha blockers who are not skating. Finishes the pass for 5 points. Omaha blocker going off for a, I believe, a direction of gameplay major.
It was a good-looking jam for Tallahassee, and then it all fell apart. 10 unanswered points so far.
Well, Tallahassee still has the potential, I think, to limit the damage here. Again, with the blocker advantage.
They got
10 seconds left on this power jam.
They got to eat up that penalty, though.
Well, they're doing
they're
a pretty
doing
solid
it.
Job. As Lomame is now released, comes back
all right,
in.
Well, you're right. You're right. They only let her get away with two scoring runs.
This is, I believe, the continuation and finish of a scoring pass for Lomame. Yep, there's...
There's four
points for Tallahassee, five for Omaha.
So it's 15-4 so far in the jam. Lomame hitters. Nice work.
Lomame with a beautiful move on the inside, squatted down underneath the Omaha blocker, and that's the end of the jam as the 2 minute ticks off.
That Omaha defense was still in power jam mode and wasn't looking for the other jammer.
So missed opportunity for Tallahassee. That they had lead jammer status. They had a blocker advantage, then sent Lomame to the penalty box. But
could have been worse.
Solid defense limits the damage, and Lomame able to come back in, score a few points of her own, makes it 162-104 with 16 minutes left in this final half of the game. Stonehurst comes to the jammer line for Tallahassee, and that is
we haven't seen much of her. A blast a girl. This is only her fifth jam of the game. We saw her a lot more in the first half. The blast a girl finds a three wall at Tallahassee in the front of the pack as the jam begins on the inside.
Stonehurst on the outside is a legal procedure.
Yeah, I don't know what that was for.
And out for lead jammer is E Blast Girl.
Huh.
Either way, both jammers now out. E-Blast Girl is the lead jammer. 20 feet behind her is Stonehurst. Both jammers now coming towards the pack. E-Blast Girl checks the position of Stonehurst. Does call it off. 2 points to none for Omaha over Tallahassee. We'll get a clarification on that illegal procedure if we can. So with 15 minutes left in the game, 164-104, Lomame comes back to the jammer line for Tallahassee. Number 777, Rady Ruck, first time jamming in the second half.
Okay, so it was an illegal procedure for a false start minor at the beginning.
He just
reiterated it as she exited the front of the pack to demonstrate why she wasn't lead jammer.
Speaking of lead jammer,
this time they do get it.
Is lead jammer for Tallahassee. Rady Ruck still on her initial pass. Good defense by Tallahassee. Rady Ruck does get out, but here comes Lomame on a scoring pass. Pushes through a two wall of Tallahassee, checks Rady Ruck's position, and calls it off.
Tallahassee, you know, playing like they're still in this thing.
You've still got plenty of time to do nickel and dime, to do 4 points, 4 points, 4 points.
And then keep your eye open for a nice power jam or something where you can put some points on the board. The winner of this game does go on to face Texas at 6 o'clock local time. That's Central. That'll be the second to last game of the day.
Oh, and Omaha is going to call a timeout. Really smart play there as they keep an eye on the 30-second clock, calling off the timeout just.
That is actually really smart, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, make it a longer timeout. Why not?
And we want to thank Union Vacations, providing a trip to the 2013 champs, wherever they might be, to the winner of the Bracket Bonanza. Don't forget, you can play the Bracket Bonanza if you go to WFTDA.com and follow through the links. Enter your picks. Talk some smack amongst your friends and teammates, and you just might win. The winner of each individual bracket, you know, be it South Central champs, what have you, will win a Jammer Up video game, as well as a complete set of the DVDs from that specific region tournament they've won. The overall champion will win a trip to the 2013 champs, courtesy of Union Vacations. So big thanks to Union Vacations for providing that. And you know, Dwayne, if you're out there watching going, man, I wish I could get my message in front of all of these roller derby fans
on
WFTDA.tv, go to WFTDA.com/sponsorship/opportunities and talk directly to thousands of derby fans by advertising on WFTDA.tv. There's affordable packages still available for your business, boot camp, or tournament advertising. Again, visit WFTDA.com/sponsorship/opportunities to learn more.
No defensive vacancy in the penalty box as the next jam begins. We got two blockers from either side, but both teams do have their jammers to face off against this micro pack. Stone Her, the jammer for Tallahassee in orange, and Animaniac for Omaha, who on the inside finds zero resistance, picks up lead jammer immediately, but she's got company. Stone Her right there with her, 5 feet back, en route to the back. She better open her eyes. Stone Her gets in front, but of course she's going to shut it down. She's going to snuff it out.
You know,
Stone Her.
You could see Animaniac, I don't think, was attempting to engage the pack. The minute she cleared the pack, she sort of started skating upright, looking at her bench. Stone Her was skating full speed. Really, Animaniac, I think purposefully allowed Stone Her to gain the advantages. Looks like Omaha is really more now focusing on...
We're getting to the point of the game where the clock starts to be your
exactly.
friend if you're up by 54 points like they are.
Going into a prevent defense, if
or whatever
you will,
it is. And
is Omaha.
Yep. 13-13 left, 164-108 Omaha. And out the front, quickly, is the jammer from Omaha. Lead jammer.
No, excuse me. Animaniac's jamming for
you're
Omaha.
Right, you're
Lomame
right.
is jamming for Tallahassee. Lomame is the lead jammer. Lomame doing everything she can to get in front of Animaniac. Lomame around on the outside, calls it off. Both jammers had gotten in. We'll see 3-3.
So many times in this game, that's what we've seen. These jammers coming out of the pack, neck to neck, matching each other on points. This is, you know, Omaha has had some good jams, some powerful jams, including right at the beginning of the game, and gotten in front of them. But the majority of this game has been a pretty neck and neck, even jammer performance out of both teams. Stone Her stands on the line once again for Tallahassee. And she faces off against Eblastigirl. It's kind of the fifth spot in the rotation, I'd say.
Stone Her was forced out of bounds, recycled all the way to the back. Eblastigirl does the same. Stone Her comes, makes her way to the front, forced out of bounds again. And she's out. Lead jammer, Stone Her. Eblastigirl still now does clear the pack.
Yeah, both jammers there, but Eblastigirl is, half a track behind Stone Her. Stone Her looking for this back of this quick-moving pack, but all of Omaha's in the front on the outside. Bumped.
I don't know that she scored any points. It looks like she was out of bounds when she passed all the blockers, and that is the call from the refs. Stone Her does not agree, but good call by the refs. She was out
Daisy
of bounds.
Daisy Mayhem sent her back. And
so 167-111 still, 11 and a half minutes left in the game. Lomame comes to the jammer line for Tallahassee in the orange. Animaniac yet again for Omaha in the black.
Got a slightly more substantial defense than we've seen a lot of times in the second half. Three on either side. Animaniac on the inside. She looks like she's going to rely on her old trick, and it works. Untouched on the inside. Animaniac, lead jammer for Omaha, but the jammer for Tallahassee is right there with her. So Lomame going to match her and actually looks like going to play some defense on each other. And watch this. Animaniac's going to take her time calling this off. Of course, she's not going to let her have any points.
Well, now you'll see you got three blockers
in
the back.
Yeah, it's completely split with all the Omaha in the front. So,
But Animaniac, you're right, does call it off as both jammers approach the pack. So, again, Omaha very kind of content to, if they get lead jammer status, let's just burn some clock.
Yeah, eat 12 more seconds and then call it dead.
Because remember, you're also burning 30 seconds off between each jam. I think they're probably, I'm suspecting the thought process is very much don't go to the penalty box. Don't go to the penalty box. Don't give Tallahassee a power jam, which is with 10 minutes left in this game and
that's
a 50-point differential.
You don't want to eat up too much clock and then have them get back in the game later on. There's not 3 minutes left. There is still 10 minutes left.
All right, so Great Wall of China versus I'm a Firestarter. I'm a Firestarter is out. Lead jammer for Omaha. Great Wall of China still in the pack. Omaha playing some solid defense. Here comes I'm a Firestarter now on a scoring pass. Cuts through the Tallahassee wall. She's around for a shave and a haircut. 5 points.
And still hung up is Great Wall of China, the Tallahassee jammer, and I'm a Firestarter.
And that was way out of play.
Yep.
But Great Wall of China now does finally clear the pack.
Daisy Mayhem was that blocker who chased her all the way to the Iowa border before playing defense on her and went to the box for it. nonetheless, you know, damage done. I'm a Firestarter enters for one more scoring pass, makes it 176 to 111 Tallahassee, and Omaha in the lead by 66 points. 9 minutes left in the game. And now,
only two Omaha blockers versus three for Tallahassee.
And we're seeing one of the blockers from Tallahassee stand on the jammer line for the first time. Ketchup is the jammer for Tallahassee this time. And she faces off against Animaniac, who comes out of the front of the pack quickly to pick up lead jammer for Omaha. Ketchup about to catch up with her as she's out as well. All of Tallahassee's defense is in the back, so maybe Animaniac's going to look for a couple of points before she calls it. I think she got frozen out.
Yeah, I don't think either point scored, any point scored by either jammer there. Yep, that's the call. So still 176 to 111, 8.5 minutes left. Lomaine comes back to the jammer line for Tallahassee. Interesting time to pull out a new jammer there by Tallahassee. I'd be curious to see what the thought process is. Maybe we'll find that out later as we go through. But again, we have Lomaine versus I'm a Firestarter.
Well, sometimes it's nice to kind of shake up the status quo if it's been pretty consistent results for the entire second half, which is what they've had.
Lomaine is the high point scorer for Tallahassee. She's working her way towards the front. She's out front with now only one blocker. Looks for an out-of-play call. She's up and around. Lead jammer is Lomaine for Tallahassee. I'm a Firestarter still in the back of the pack, forced out of bounds by number 32, La Voodoo.
Axel Rogue was the defender who got a piece of Lomaine there for a minute, but Lomaine bounces
I'm a back. Firestarter hugged the inside line. Lomaine, though, does finish scoring pass by four, scores 4 points for Tallahassee, but Gwen, I don't know if you saw that. I'm a Firestarter hit at almost out of bounds, was just able to snug the inside line all the way around the apex of turns 3 and 4 to stay in bounds.
No, she did not. She crossed over the line. Sure enough, we were just bragging about her tightrope walking skills, but it looks like she fell straight off to the inside, and it's going to be a power jam for Tallahassee. How about that?
And you know, I'm kind of curious about the timing of that call. Either way, the jam is off. Lomaine is lead jammer for Tallahassee. Only two blockers versus one on the track right now. Two more Omaha blockers come out, and we're now 3-on-3 blocker-wise.
Oh, man, snuck through a closing sliding door there, and a five-point pass for Lomaine, and she's going in for another one. Oh, Lomaine's, solid wall of Omaha.
Lomaine's coming in so fast. No back block called. I think good call by the
Yeah.
Back block called by the refs.
I forgot to tell you, we went ahead and gave the refs an earpiece from your microphone so that they could contradict you as often as possible.
So we should be playing jammer rotation. Both jammers sitting in the penalty box. I'm a Firestarter is released.
Man, what great break for Omaha. But, you know, she was only in for, what, 40 seconds? So Stoneher, going to come back.
Oh, coming through on the inside untouched. That's 5 points for I'm a Firestarter. 6 minutes left in this game. This is it for Omaha.
Yep. On the inside, she's going back for another one just like that. Push to the inside. Got to recycle herself. And again. Boy, that blocker for Tallahassee doing a great job on the inside.
LaVoodoo almost connected with on the Firestarter. Lomaine is out. That was another scoring pass. So 27 seconds left in this jam. Both jammers scoring points.
Aaron Brakovich was the one doing just a great job on the inside, bumping her repeatedly, making her re-recycle herself. And now I'm a Firestarter. Completes the scoring run. Now she completes another one for 4 points. So, boy, it looked like a promising jam at the beginning for Tallahassee, but Omaha has turned this around.
Lomaine finishes a four-point scoring pass. I'm a Firestarter now in the pack. She's knocked out of bounds by La Voodoo recycles. And that's the end of the jam. Huge missed opportunity there by Tallahassee. You had lead jammer status. You had a huge positional advantage, a pack advantage. And Lomaine just came in so fast right into the back of that wall. When you're going to come in like that, you've got to at least put a shoulder into them. She came full, hit them in the back.
Do anything. Put your hands in the air so that there's just no confusion, but instead a back block major. And
when you knock down two blockers like that, you really make it easy on the refs to call the back block major.
probably the last big opportunity for Tallahassee, but we shall see. 4.5 minutes left, 193-128 Omaha.
Stoneher versus Animaniac. Animaniac is out lead jammer for Omaha. Stoneher working her way towards the front. Pack is all spread out. No pack briefly called. Minor play, excuse me, out of play minors being called. But here comes Animaniac on a scoring pass, who finishes the pass, and now here's some heady play by Omaha. Does not immediately calls it off. Watches, waves to Stoneher. Stoneher waves back, and Animaniac calls it off, burning off a few more seconds of that clock, Dwayne. Really, really good time clock awareness on the part of Omaha.
And she did pick up three of her own as well. So that makes it 197. Omaha getting really close to the double century. 128 is what Tallahassee has on the board. 3.5 minutes left in the game.
And catch-up comes back to the jammer line for the second time in this contest.
Rady Ruck hasn't been on the line too much, but she goes back again. The rest of the jammers for Omaha have had over 20 jams. Rady Ruck has only had 6 or 7.
Oh, catch-up tried to cut through on the inside line. The door was closed. Now she's up front with a good three wall.
All
she's
right.
Out.
She got her first lead jammer of the game. Catch-up for Tallahassee, and they're still after it. 70-point lead by Omaha. Only a couple of jams left, but Tallahassee going to try to make it look better on paper. Catch-up on the inside, looking for an open lane, but she is bumped out by number two, Makilia, the defender for Omaha, has to recycle herself.
Rady Ruck does get out.
So it's going to keep her from getting a grand slam, but catch-up still in it. And really, Makilia stuffs her on the inside. Man, oh, man, and she... Was it elbow major?
I believe it was a fourth minor. I think out of play. I didn't see the call. Rady, catch-up, though.
Giving her hell no matter what it was.
Really impressive jam there by catch-up as she danced around for that last point. Solid effort there by catch-up, though, with 2 minutes 20 seconds left. 197 for Omaha, 132 for Tallahassee.
I Am a Fire Starter goes to the line against Low Mame. I Am a Fire Starter for Omaha, Low Mame for Tallahassee, the team in their signature iconic bright orange. And the Low Mame, the jammer for Tallahassee, taken down as she enters the backfield. I Am a Fire Starter, the jammer for Omaha, back on her feet, but no, out of nowhere, Low Mame gets it. Low Mame back on her feet out the front of the pack, lead jammer Tallahassee.
So I'm a Fire Starter does now finish her initial pass through the pack, about 60 feet, separate the jammers. Here comes Low Mame coming in hot, coming in around.
Oh, man, just runs into a brick wall in the form of the defender, Danielle Inyakoffin, the defender for Omaha. Man, looked like a bug on a windshield.
Low Mame thought she had an inside line, and the door was about halfway open. I think she thought she could sneak through.
She thought she could have it, but she gambled and lost.
Danielle Inyakoffin with a huge hit. Low Mame is going to feel that.
No doubt about it. Low Mame just put on the highway.
All right, Animaniac comes back to the jammer line for Omaha against Stoneher. 1 minute left in the game. This could be the last jam. We'll see what happens. Working up front, looking for an out-of-play call. There it is. Animaniac is out for lead jammer for Omaha. And, Dwayne, that should do it.
Probably going to wrap it up. Only 43 seconds left on the jam clock. We'll see what happens. Animaniac. Certainly, eyes set on the scoreboard.
I'm kind of surprised to see her even engage the pack the way they've been playing this second half.
Honestly, you're right.
Animaniac, though, up front. She gets forced out of bounds. And
well, hey! Huh.
And with 23 seconds left, Tallahassee's got a timeout. We'll see if they call it here.
Are they aware of how much time is left on the game clock?
I think they are. Or
yeah,
oh, yeah,
they
there
are.
We go.
There they go. Firing it off. So, yeah, they're going to try to, but you know what? Omaha now over the century mark, double. 201-138. Omaha over Tallahassee. 8 seconds is where the clock is frozen. And, of course, they're not going to score 63 points in the last jam, but, you know, we'll see. Tallahassee with a great debut in the WFTDA postseason. I'm impressed.
It really is. I mean, again, they've had a couple of mental snafus that we've talked about, but overall a really solid effort to start off start off their WFTDA playoff experience.
Yeah, you know, they've kept a really good head on their shoulders, and they didn't let they never got, you know, it's tough to see it from up here, but they never got too emotional. They stayed in there. Every time Omaha got their jammer out the front of the pack, they were really good about sticking with them and forcing them to call off the jam. You know, it's such a cliche to say, oh, that team played with a lot of heart, but in this case, I think it's actually true. They actually, you know, stayed in it till the very end. 10 seconds left on the clock, and it looks like the action about to go back underway. 201-138, Omaha over Tallahassee to end the first
game of this playoff tournament. So we got I'm a Firestarter versus Ketchup. Ketchup works her way towards the front. Nice hop and skip.
Very nice.
She is lead jammer for Tallahassee. I'm a Firestarter, though, does get out. Clock ticks down to zero, so this is it. When this jam ends, so does the game.
Ketchup wanting to put as many points on the board as she can. Hey, nice work.
Scores 4 points.
Swoops right in there. Yep. Shuts it down, so they'll be that much closer. 201 to 142. Tallahassee by no means blown out or anything. I mean, they were in it the whole time, so not a bad debut performance in the WFTDA postseason for Tallahassee. But in the end, Omaha comes out on top, and they will go on to face the Texas Rollergirls, the number one seed, this evening at 6 p.m.